good Saturday morning, DFW. I like that there's just a little chill in the air, and I just love fall. Fall is just a great season, and we've got an action-packed show today. We're going to begin with a segment. Many of you remember that great movie from several years ago called Finding Forrester, starring Sean Connery. I think I've got a real-life Finding Forrester here in the studio. Dr. John McCready is with an organization called Free Minds Dallas. The website is freemindsdallas.org. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Jeff. I'm pleased to be here.
Okay, so tell us what Free Minds Dallas is.
So Free Minds offers accredited humanities courses to economically disadvantaged persons here in the Dallas area. We've been doing it about 4 years. We teach a 9-month course over the course of a regular academic year. And we offer classes in critical thinking, art, literature, history, and philosophy. And the course really began back in the early 80s with a man named Earl Shorris. And he was looking at poverty, and he realized the kinds of effects that poverty was having on individual human lives, not the poor in the aggregate, but individual human lives. And he wanted to do something about it. And he ended up visiting a prison where he read Shakespeare with some of these students and found that they were transformed after the engagement. After reading these texts and after having these discussions, suddenly they were able to think for themselves. They felt more confident in their ability to have engaged conversations and were concerned about the world around them. And Earl thought that if he founded a course like this, where he could go to underserved communities and read with them and teach them how to write and how to think, that they might find a way to liberate themselves. He knew he couldn't liberate them, but he knew that he might be able to empower people who are economically disadvantaged so that they could begin to free themselves and change their lives. And so that's what we're doing here. We started out at City Square, and now we have two campuses, one at El Centro, where we offer a Saturday course, and then one in the Fraser Courts in South Dallas, where we offer a class 2 nights a week, and it's been really rewarding.
Tell me one of your favorite stories or students. I mean, when you think about this program, does somebody come to mind?
There are. I mean, I want to protect the anonymity of the students, but I can think of a student from our course last year who seemed to struggle with a lot of the ideas that we were covering and how to fit those into her life. And by the time graduation arrived, she had found a text that really spoke to her, and this often happens. It may be towards the end of the course that a text really begins to speak to a student, and that becomes theirs, and they kind of take ownership of those ideas, and it becomes a kind of threshold moment for them where they cross over into a new way of life. And at graduation, she gave a very moving speech that drew on all of the texts that we had been reading, but particularly this one that resonated with her. And I think in that moment, as a teacher, that's where you really feel like the work you're doing is making a difference in the community.
I think it's in TV news they would call it a fish out of water story, because they you wouldn't think that bringing Shakespeare into the hood necessarily would be popular or resonate with students, but you're finding that's true.
Well, I should point out that we've been the National Clemente course. Mm-hmm. Shakespeare figures pretty prominently. We have taken a different kind of path here in Dallas. We have diversified our readings, and so we read Ta-Nehisi Coates, and we read Frederick Douglass, and we read indigenous authors and plays, and bring a kind of critical voice to the Western canon. So we do read Nietzsche and Plato and the Constitution and those kinds of things, but we also try to bring some critical voices that are also resonate with the community.
So. Do you get excited when class begins? Like, are you already kind of seeing, I know in the next 30 days these lives will be transformed and they don't even know it yet?
Yeah, absolutely. We just took the class to see Deferred Action at the Latino Cultural Center, and this was on the heels of spending several weeks on Martin Luther King Jr.'s A Letter from a Birmingham Jail, in which he comments that, you know, they're being told, just wait, not right now, just wait. And so at the intermission, the students were already beginning to see the connections between the letter we had just read, that this happened in our nation's history, and now we're looking at another event in our nation's history where people are saying, you should probably just wait.
That's
before
cool.
you work for liberations.
Are you kind of a natural teacher? Has this always been a gift for you?
I love it. I think you do have to work at teaching. I think you have to be intentional about the way you set up the classroom and the way you organize the material, and I think you have to know your students. So I'm not sure that we're born teachers. I think it does take work. So I'm definitely someone who loves the discipline, and I would teach probably as long as I could eat and have a place to live, I would probably do it.
Right. I mentioned Finding Forrester earlier. I'm now thinking maybe Dead Poets Society, too. There was a little, you know, Robin Williams in that great role brought poetry alive for young people. And I think it's kind of magical when you can do that.
Yeah, we have a professor that's joined us this year, Jason Carney, and he's a local poet and author. And he's actually bringing poems into the classroom to teach, and then he's going to connect them with contemporary poets through Skype so that the students can read the poems, analyze them, and then actually respond to the poets live in the classroom. So those kinds of experiences, I think, are so beneficial. We're already beginning to see students who, once they know what an argument is and what the elements of an argument are, we're already beginning to see them require other students to produce reasons for their claims or evidence for their claims in the classroom. And that empowers people with a kind of confidence to speak and act for themselves in the public.
Do you ever have students come back a year or two later and say, you've changed my life?
We have, and we have them join the course again, even though they're not taking the course, come back and sit in the classroom and say, listen, this is an amazing course. You got to stick it out because it is difficult, and we have about a 50% attrition rate in the course. But they inspire other students to stay in.
That's amazing. Give us the website again and how people can get involved. Are you needing donations right now?
Yeah, we could really use a lot more support. We've partnered with Fraser Revitalization. They've been an amazing partner with us, and El Centro College has also been a big partner. But they can reach us at Free Minds Dallas, and donations can be made by contacting us through that website. And we are looking for support for next year. It does take a lot to provide this to the community. But just as some results from a big study that has just been done on the course by a doctoral student at the University of Chicago, they found that the majority of students within at least a year of graduating from the Clemente course go on to further their education. They vote more. They're more likely to be volunteers in their communities. And so our aim is really to inspire civic engagement. And we find that that's happening in Dallas, and that makes a real difference.
That's awesome. Dr. John McCready, freemindsdallas.org is the website. Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks, Jeff.
When we come back, one of our regular Legal Eagle segments with one of Dallas's top attorneys. That's next on The Jeff Crilly Show.
More of The Jeff Crilly Show coming up.